normal part of life. Like when we hear females, even sometimes we hear big people talk like that and say bunnies are normal part of life. It just irritates my soul, and it just shows how much society has deteriorated, and how even the big woman them were supposed to tell the young girl them say no, not accept anything. These are the same big woman that are telling the young girls that hey, it is normal, and that means if you ever tell somebody say normal, that means it is acceptable for you to get it. And if you are going to tell people that, they're going to just settle. If you are going to tell young girls that, that means they're just going to settle for any or anything. And so that is what, those are some of the things that I want to speak about on this platform. Those are some of the things that I want to really encourage females against, and to encourage females to value themselves. Because once you learn to value yourself, then you don't give room to anybody basically taking advantage of you in your life.
So hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I'm so excited to be sharing with you all today more content. I'm even more excited for all of the new subscribers that I've gained over the last few weeks. A lot of you guys are persons that I know personally, and it's kind of weird like putting myself out there sharing with you all so much personal stuff, considering that I consider myself to be a very private person. But at the same time, the agenda is not based off me really, but it is just about sharing with other persons, whether sinners or Christian girls, guys or men or women. It's about sharing my journey as a Christian, my journey of singleness, my journey of purity, and just sharing all of the experiences that I've gained as a Christian. I think that I have garnered enough experience to have enough information to help to encourage other young females and Christian males along the journey of, you know, serving God. One of the main reasons why I started my YouTube channel really was to motivate others. As a young Christian person, I have had the opportunity of having my best friend with me on this journey, and my cousin. They're like two of the main persons that have helped me and offered great support during my singleness. And also, they have truly been like accountability partners to me. And one of the main things that I encourage Christian girls to do on the journey, you need Christian people as your friend. I wanted to be the representation that I wanted to see. You have a lot of YouTubers, Jamaican YouTubers specifically, who put out a lot of content, pranks, relationship YouTubers and all of that, which is okay and good in itself, and you have makeup YouTubers as well. But you don't really have a lot of Christian Jamaican YouTubers who are pushing purity, who are pushing holiness, who are helping, offering information about how to groom yourself to for marriage, how to elevate yourself as a woman, pushing women having good self-esteem, pushing women growing, and just the overall development of women and Christian young people. So I wanted to see that, so I said okay, I need to just do it. I wasn't super comfortable about putting myself out there, because a lot of persons that I know who don't even know a lot of the stuff that I put here on YouTube, who I talk to personally. So it kind of weird, it was very weird initially, and like gave me anxiety initially to be like putting all my information out there like that. But I guess at the end of the day, God kind of has been like talking to me about doing it for a long time, because I made the YouTube page like a long time now, but I didn't really put out personal stuff on it, and it was kind of distant because I didn't really share it with persons who were close to me. But now I kind of just took the whole leap and just like diving, and like, you know what, whatever, whosoever wants to see it, see it. So I have been involved in doing motivational speaking at a number of institutions across Jamaica. At the age of 18, I started sharing at my church, and I was like really encouraged. I felt really excited just talking to young girls, encouraging them that hey, you can be where you want to be in a life. You know, have to settle. Because in my own community, I saw a lot of young girls, basically a lot of them not even finish high school. A lot of them drop out because them end up get pregnant, and as a result of that, them just drop out of school. And this was something that really bothered me, and this was not something that I wanted for myself. This was not something that I wanted for the young girls at my church. This was not something I wanted for my family or for many Jamaicans. I believe that you can go to school, get your high school diploma, get your degree,
start your career, have a career, get your family, get yourself settled in life, accomplish something for yourself, and then you can start your family and all that. But I realized that it was like the young girls in my community, they were just seeing other young girls who were above them basically get pregnant, drop out of school, and then that would be it for them, and then the whole cycle just continue and it continue and it continue. But I was like, no, I didn't want this for myself, and I had the ambition. I, not just me, but God kind of inspired me to have the ambition to pursue a different path and to work hard and to study hard and to just like focus myself and to not settle for certain stuff and fall into certain traps. But it never just comes up. So I wanted to share what I had learned with other young girls and with other young men to work hard. A lot of them grew up in poverty-stricken situation. A lot of them grew up in kind of like weird situations, yes. And sometimes even life sometimes against you, and it's hard, and then you're just like, you know, just success will just fall into your lap like that. So even I had my own journey, and I wanted to share that journey to encourage others. And so that is why I started doing these motivational talks. And I would never, I've never asked to speak anywhere, because as I say, I consider myself a shy person somewhat, and more introverted than anything else. But at the same time, people would just keep asking me somehow, and I realized that this was my purpose in life, really, was to encourage others, because somehow people always came to me out of the blue, weird. People would just come to me and ask me to come speak at this school, speak at that school or whatever, and encourage young girls. I realized there are lots of young girls who do not have those kind of people to influence them to live righteous, to influence them to have ambition, to influence them to pursue a career and to really go hard for making themselves into something of value. Just consider this as an opportunity and a platform for me to speak to other young girls, because I realize even in society nowadays, perversion is really being glorified in a humiliating way and a disgraceful kind of way. I want to be that encourager, that motivator, that person that pushes young females to not settle for mediocrity. So this channel is not just about Christian girls not having sex. It's not about that. That is just a small part. It's about self-worth, people valuing themselves, people pushing to have their career. And if you want to be a part of the family, just subscribe to this video. Subscribe to my channel and like.